I like to give people a challenge. I'm curious, I want everyone listening for the next 7 days to try something. Mm-hmm. And if you could give 1 to 3 different things that we could think differently or eliminate mm-hmm. when a thought comes to us or we react in a certain way. If there's something you think that if we eliminated 1, 2, or 3 things and we did this every day for 7 mm-hmm. days, we would start to see incredible mm-hmm. feelings differently, would feel healthier, more lively, more love. What would okay. be those few things?
Okay, well, most people, number one, they get up in the morning and they check their cell phone, they check their text, their WhatsApp, their Facebook, they post something on Facebook, drive to work the same way, do the same thing. So they're in a program. They've actually lost their free will to the program.
Wow.
So if you start your day and you start your day with this simple question, what is the greatest ideal of myself that I can be today? Mm. You ask yourself that question. Now listen, your body's gonna go like, well, we gotta get a cup of coffee and you gotta
I'm tired.
And you gotta go, body, you're not the mind, I'm the mind right now. You're gonna sit here, I'm gonna feed you, you're gonna get your coffee, you're gonna do all those things, but right now, this is my time. You're gonna obey me, right? So now, the body's no longer the mind, you're the mind. And so when it wants to get up and you become aware of it and return back to the present moment, every time you do, that's a victory. Wow. And you're changing some aspect of yourself. So then ask yourself, I do this all the time, write down 4 thoughts that you're gonna stay conscious of the whole day. I can't, it's too hard. You'd be surprised the moment you become conscious of what those thoughts are, how unconscious you've been to them all day, right. You know, for weeks on end. Write down what you speak, how you speak, 4 things you wanna change, how you act. How do you act? Do you complain? Do you blame? Do you make excuses? Do you feel sorry for yourself? That's a victim consciousness. What emotions do you live by? Is it possible that you're so used to living by guilt you don't even know it's guilt, it just feels like you? Do you allow your energy to drop? Become conscious of those states of mind and body and review them and say, this is the old self. Then say, what thoughts do I want to fire and wire in my brain? And start firing and wiring and start feeling it. What behaviors will I demonstrate today? What choices will I make? One day, one lifetime. Mm. And just like you did, rehearse them. Rehearse the whole entire thing. Yeah. Begin to install the neurological hardware in your brain. And if you keep installing it, the hardware is going to become a software program. You're going to start thinking and acting that way. And then here's the tough part. Can you teach your body emotionally what your future is going to feel like before it's made manifest? Mm. And don't get up until you feel that way. Now, practice that for a few days and then see if you can stay in that state and watch all of a sudden all those weird doors start opening for you.
Synchronicities,
yeah. Whatever they are. Number two, take a time at the end of your day, before you lay down and give thanks for your life and feel gratitude and really teach your body what it feels like. The emotional signature of gratitude, when gratitude means you're getting something. If I give you something that's of value, you would say thank you because you would feel it, right? So when you're receiving, you're giving thanks. So gratitude is the ultimate state of receiving. Mm. So then people only accept, believe, and surrender to the thoughts equal to their emotional state. So if you're in a state of gratitude, every thought's gonna make it right down into your body. If you're saying, I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, and your body's programmed in negativity, it's saying, no, you're not, that thought's gonna stop right here. So as you elevate your state, there are about 1,200 different chemical reactions that go on in the body that begin to restore and repair the body in a state of gratitude. And so we've done the research to prove that. 10 minutes, and just feel it with all of your heart. That's it.
Wow.
Third thing, and very important, take time, whenever it is, sit down, close your eyes, and begin to just open your awareness to the space around you, and just sense it, and pay attention to it, and become more aware of it. The act of opening your awareness begins to reduce the stress hormones and creates more coherent brainwave states. I'm doing it right now. It's just a practice.
Yeah.
It's just a practice. And the more you do it, the better you get.